Take a moment. Take a deep breath. Think carefully and relax. After all, today is about getting to know who you really are.
You guys excited?
So excited.
I'm pretty excited.
Yeah. This is your first interview?
It's my first interview.
It's my fifth.
Oh, wow.
This is my very first interview, and actually my last interview, so I'm actually very nervous about this.
Oh, yeah? Are you ready for it?
I heard about Western.
Actually, I heard about Western from a forum called Premium 101.
Here in London, yeah, this woman.
I did my hair as well.
Quite a few creepers on that forum. I remember one in particular.
That's good. I mean, don't be nervous. You'll do great.
That's all I know.
Charm too.
I don't know. What if I forgot my tell me something about yourself answer because I've just prepared for it in my car.
Oh, you're gonna be so totally ready for that question. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I think you're asking.
Yeah.
I prepared like 10 pages of notes for that.
Really?
Yeah.
Hey, welcome to the Schillig School of Medicine and Dentistry. You're here for your interview, right?
Yeah.
Well, fantastic.
Wait,
I've been here before.
You're going to tell me to
have
some of that
some
rancid
treatments.
Coffee. And then you're going to tell me your name is
my name's
Nadia.
Hey, I hope you're excited about the school. I can tell you a lot more about it if you'd like.
Sure.
Western University's medical school was founded in 1881 and merged with the dental program in 1997. In 2005, it changed its name to Schulich School of Medicine and Dentistry after a $25 million endowment from Seymour Schulich.
And unbuttoned his already inappropriately buttoned shirt.
Each year,
and that guy with the backpack is going
to
walk up and steal all the food on the table.
In fact, last year, our acceptance rate was
going on here
7%.
Wait, 7?
Damn it, Mike! Stop taking food!
I've got a big, snuggly orange cat named Aerosol.
Oh, cute! I love the name. That's great.
Well, thank you.
Just looking at the time, I think it's time to go to the interview. So, shall we start walking?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I had to, you know, get in my Mercedes-Benz and clean it off.
No, speaking of time, do you know what time it is?
Yeah.
Looks like it's time for us to go to the interview.
It's like it's a little cold in here.
You like it, huh?
How did you drive here?
Oh, no, I walked.
You, do up that shirt! And you. Let's go, guys. Interview time.
Okay, so there's been a bit of a mix-up at the office. We don't actually have a group to interview today.
But my letter...
Don't worry, it's definitely not your fault.
So, what happens now?
Well, it seems the only option is to have you come back another day.
Not the only option.
Doctor, what do you mean?
I'll do her interview.
Well, I guess that would be okay. Just make sure she signs the waiver and consent form.
Yeah, yeah. Violet? Come on.
consent.
Violet, do you know what my research at Schulich entails? I'm part of the Department of Interview Sciences, and I study the interview process, specifically the medical school interview. It's my hypothesis that the standard medical school interview doesn't quite capture the full picture of a person. So I've developed a new method of interviewing, one that should revolutionize the admissions process all over the world. Well, it's about time. Third door down on your right.
Are you doing an interview with us?
Yeah, I guess so.
So, do you know what's going on now?
We're in my mind?
Precisely. Instead of getting you to talk about your experiences, we're going to observe your memories directly.
Whoa. How did you get this past your ethics board? This seems really invasive.
Perhaps. But in all fairness, it is your mind. I can only see what you decide to recall. Pretty cool, huh?
So, this is all just a memory? But it seems so real. All the anxiety and the anticipation came back.
Yes. Emotional recall is all part of the process. You'll experience the same emotional state you did when the memories were originally formed.
Well, in that case, can we not revisit my awkward years?
Like I said, it's your mind. You're in control of what I see, as long as you're in control of your mind.
No pressure, right?
Just your future. Shall I proceed?
Let's do this.
Let's start off with a softball question. Everyone has different strengths, and those strengths complement each other. What are your strengths? What am I looking at here?
I'm studying.
That's your greatest strength?
I'm bouncing back. You can see what I got on that last test.
Yeah, so?
So, I stayed up all night studying. I put everything else on the line to dedicate myself to the subject.
The subject of Introduction to Computational Chemistry.
Yeah.
Do you use that knowledge often?
It was really important at the time.
Who is that?
Nobody.
Nobody? Do they know you call them that?
He understands that I'm really busy, and I have all these things to do, and...
Did you ever answer?
But look how dedicated I am to medical school, how much I study,
Oh, I'm sure you study very hard.
And there's more on my application. I've done some shadowing with a physician, and,
Oh, yes. I see here that you've done some shadowing with a physician in the Department of Diagnostic Medicine? That's a department? They don't do anything but diagnose.
Just like the Department of Interview Sciences doesn't do anything but interview.
Fair enough. Show me.
Well, I've been thinking about it a lot, and I think that medicine is something I really want to go into.
Well, I think it's great that you're getting this experience. Working with Dr. Kondo is... Well, it's quite the experience.
Well, wait, you're not Dr. Kondo?
No, Dr. Kondo is...
Brilliant? I know. You have a patient. Differential diagnosis. Alopecia, low platelet white count, and pleural effusion. Go!
Endocarditis. The infection tanks his cell count, and the heart failure causes pleural effusion. It fits!
And the alopecia? I know hair loss is normal in Dr. Evil over here, but in us normals it means something's wrong.
MMI syndrome. The stress causes the hair loss, and falling down in a pool of your own cold tears leads to the white cell count and pleural effusion.
This isn't McMaster. We cure diseases with medicine, not verbal reasoning.
Hey, I went to McMaster.
Yes, and you're an idiot. I only hired you because you wear low-cut tops and yoga pants.
Watch this. It could be lupus.
It's never lupus.
Doesn't anyone ever knock around here?
Dr. Kondo, you're supposed to be in the clinic 3 hours ago.
That's funny, because I had no intention of being in the clinic 3 hours ago.
If you don't want to do your clinic hours, have one of your lackeys do it for you.
Lucky number one, put on a more revealing top and biopsy the patient's abdomen.
Her whole abdomen?
Her whole abdomen? Dr. Baldstein, ultrasound the patient's chest and look for a bleeding heart. That'll tell us if we should send her to Mac. Lupus. Break into the patient's house.
What am I looking for?
Cash, electronics, jewelry. Oh, and black fungal spores. Haven't you ever been eaten before? Leave your coat. New girl, cover my clinic duty.
But I'm not a real doctor.
It's clinic duty. A monkey with a tissue and a bottle of Motrin could do it.
But shouldn't I know some medicine before I go in?
Do you want your reference letter?
Suppose you could spare one for my head.
So, how may I help you today, miss?
Okay, so over the last few months, I've been, like, gaining some weight, and I can't really figure out why. I look at my scale and it keeps telling me I'm getting heavier and heavier, and then sometimes I, like, look down and I can't even see the scale anymore. But then I also get these, like, really strange cravings.
For, like, food?
Like, cravings to go to the mall. Like, I really crave going to the mall and buying, like, a lot of things. But then, while I'm at the mall, I, like, really, really need to pee. But then, I'm, like, worried about going to the public bathrooms because, you know, all the diseases you can get on the toilet and all that stuff. And, like, I'm a virgin, you know.
You mean a Virgo.
So I was with this girl last night, being all charming and gentleman-like, you know, getting my Ryan Gosling on. I was all, like... Hey girl, I wrote you 365 letters. Why didn't you write back? Long story short, she ended up reading my notebook. You know what I'm saying? Give me some love!
So, what brings you in today?
Well, ever since I was with that girl, some things haven't felt the same. My boys, not those boys, told me that I should get my boys checked out. Those boys.
What does it feel like?
Well, like all the ladies know, my crotch is usually pretty hot, if you know what I mean. But lately...
crotch on fire. Got it.
So what do you think it is, Doc?
Well, from what you've told me, it sounds like you have an STI. Maybe chlamydia.
What's that?
The clap.
Oh, the clap? Why didn't you say so? That's awesome!
This is a fairly serious infection. How is this good news?
Bro, I heard they call it that because it's like a trophy, right? Once you've been with enough girls, you show your boys to your boys, and they applaud. The clap!
Boy.
This is so much cooler than when I had gonorrhea.
I need to see the doctor now. He's busy at the moment.
No, he doesn't. Willow wants the doctor. Willow needs the doctor. Willow hates the doctor.
Can I help you with anything?
No.
I'm fine. Just here to see Dr. Kondo.
Okay.
Kondo did this to us. Here's the blame. Kondo!
Look, I think you need a psych referral. Or an exorcism.
Where's it going? What's it doing, Precious?
I'm just gonna go page Dr. Kondo.
Let's take a walk. I think I've seen enough here. You've shown me that you're dedicated, hardworking, that you can bounce back from failure. And deal with new and very, very strange situations. These are all very important characteristics of a physician. But there's more than that to life. That phone call you screened earlier.
I mean, it really wasn't a big deal. It was just a small thing that came up.
Okay. Why don't you show me how you are outside of your work?
Hey.
Hi.
Come on in. Wow,
it's good to see you.
Yeah.
I'm sorry I'm late. I was studying and then I just completely lost track of my mind.
No, let me get that. I understand. You're studying. You seem nervous. Are you nervous about meeting my mom?
Well, that's an understatement. When is she supposed to be getting here again?
Pretty soon. I think, the next 10 minutes or something? Yeah, you better get close.
Splendid. What am I supposed to say to her? What if I make a bad impression?
Relax, it'll be fine. I mean, what's the worst that could happen?
Oh, hello! You must be the girl who's taking my son away from me!
She wouldn't actually say that, would she?
Yeah, she might.
Well, no, Mrs. Nunez. Madam Nunez? Senora Nunez! Como estás?
Oh. Ooh. Okay. Okay.
By the way, what would you like for lunch?
May I have some salad?
You hate salad. Why are you doing this? Why?
I don't want to come off as some slob or something.
Don't try to impress me so much.
After all, I just want a relaxing afternoon with my son and his girlfriend.
Well, I want her to like me, and you say that she has a tendency to hate all the girls you bring home.
I have a tendency to hate people too. I didn't really like you much when I first met you.
Oh, thanks.
Sorry. I didn't mean to say that. What I meant to say was like, once you let your guard down, you're just like way easier to get to know and be around. It's just like when you're first meeting people, you put on this show and, bet. So just be yourself and things will work out.
But what if
I found some leaves for you to eat?
You know what? Forget the leaves. Can I have some meat? I need meat. Do you have a burger or a steak or anything?
I think I can do that.
Gracias.
You know that.
Interesting choice, that's for sure. What about group work? Have you done any team sports or group activities?
Yeah, it's all listed in the hobby section of my application.
Yes, let's see. You've listed dancing, baking, group yoga, band, and... Oh, I'm a huge tennis fan. Let's see some tennis.
You know, tennis really isn't a team sport.
Forget about that. I want to see your tennis skills. Seriously? Seriously?
Hey, it's more intense than it looks. And I'm a pro, according to Wii Sports. Well, it may have been a bit of a stretch.
A bit? What's going on here?
It was just a little fib.
I don't know, Violet. Something doesn't feel right here.
What do you mean?
I feel like there are things you're trying to avoid. Something important you're trying to cover up with all this fluff.
Well, it's personal. And it has no bearing on me as a candidate.
Everything has to do with you as a candidate. This interview is about so much more than just the hard numbers. We want to get to know you as a person. What makes you tick? What makes you stumble? It's important for us to know who you are.
This looks familiar.
I know.
Did you answer this time?
Didn't need to.
You're unbelievable.
Excuse me?
I'd never do something like that to you, the way you ignore me.
You know that I have the test tomorrow.
Can we do this somewhere else?
Right now. I need to get back to my books.
Let me for a second, please.
Yeah, you don't understand. Oh my god. You know what happened last time.
So it's my fault you failed that test? You really regret that one time you picked me over school, eh?
I never said that. God, I hate it when you get like this.
I hate it that you ignore me every time a test rolls around. It takes 1 second to text me back.
I can't do this right now. I need to study.
This is what I mean. You expect the whole world to stop just so you can study. It's like med school's the only thing that matters to you.
Med school's the most important thing in my life.
Okay.
Look, I didn't mean it that way.
It's okay, you don't have to pretend with me anymore.
I'm sorry. I'll make it up to you. I promise.
That's all you do, you just make promises.
You didn't go after him?
I think I've had enough of this interview. What's going on?
I don't know. I've never seen anything like this happen before. I think an emotional memory is surfacing. It looks like you're not quite done with this interview yet. Just go with it.
Interviewing at Schulich? That's exciting.
I guess so. It doesn't seem like it anymore.
Why? If you got an interview, it means you worked hard for it.
How would you know?
I was a medical student. I know what it takes to get here, and what it does to you. How would getting an interview not matter?
I don't know what it takes. I don't know how to care for people. I don't know. I feel like I've been really selfish, that I've made some really bad decisions. I don't have my priorities straight, and I don't know what's important to me in life anymore. I can't even take care of myself. I don't know how to take care of anyone else. How could I ever become a doctor?
Everyone makes these mistakes, and it's okay. No one really knows it's a mistake until it's done. We're all just people after all, even doctors. And if there's one thing you can count on, it's that we'll make mistakes. On our exams, in our interviews, in our personal lives, and in our practice. It happens. You just have to be okay with that and find the courage to go on anyways.
I guess so. Just sacrifice so much for what? A few grades. Really, what does that show of me as a person? Like, what's the point of it all?
You only think that because you're on this side of things. You have your head down and your eyes set on one goal. You're trying to be the perfect medical student. Someone with a 4.0 GPA, 45 on the MCAT, 3 first author publications, thousands of volunteer hours. Someone who spent their summer days in Africa digging wells with their bare hands, and spent their summer nights writing apology letters to all the children who didn't get exactly what they wanted for Christmas. That person doesn't exist. They're just something dreamt up by pre-meds who need something to strive towards. Medicine doesn't need that. We need a real person. Someone who is as flawed as they are brilliant. Someone who is humbled by their mistakes, yet find the courage to continue on. Damaged, perhaps, but who is a genuine human being.
I don't know if I can be that person.
No, I wouldn't say that. Look at where you are. You could be preparing for your interviews, or an exam, or something else boring, but you're here. Here to care for the people that you love. Don't worry, I'm sure everything will be fine. Your mother's going to walk out of this hospital, and soon enough, you'll walk in with your white coat on.
How could you possibly know that?
Trust me, I'm a doctor.
I've looked over your application. Extracurriculars, volunteer experience, research, solid GPA, good MCAT. All in all, a pretty fine application. Fine, and that's all. Do you know why we've started these memory interviews? It's because we're interested in the sum total of you. We're interested in your experiences, all the pieces of your life, everything that you've done, the people that you've known, the engagements that you've had, these all go together to make you an individual, make you part of the whole. I want you to look around. These individuals, these colleagues, these people will one day be your friends, maybe your mentors, they may become part of your family. You are in excellent hands. These are the people that you're going to learn with and are to become part of our family. There's one spot left.